Hello guys, One Man Dev is here, and in this tutorial I'll be covering how to create your rule tiles so you will never have to draw your tile map one tile at a time. So let's get straight into it. First off, look for your tile map image, then turn sprite mode from single to multiple. And if you don't turn it to multiple, then you can't slice it into multiple tiles. And now select slice option and hit change automatic from grid by cell size. And because we are working with a 16 by 16 tile map, we are going to slice our tile map into 16 by 16 pixel size. And hit slice. And as you can see, our tile map looks perfect, so hit apply. And now close this sprite editor window. And now if we expand our tile map, we should see that Unity has sliced them into multiple tiles. And now go to Window, Package Manager, and make sure if you have your 2D tile map extras installed. Otherwise, we won't be able to make our rule tiles. Make sure you are on your project window, right click, create, go to 2D, tile map, and then select rule tiles. And as you can see, Unity has created a new rule tile for us. Name it to whatever you want. I'm going to name it dirt inside, dirt inner. Now I'm going to drag a dirt tile for our default sprite. And as you can see, we can drag it into here. Select a rule tile and click on this lock icon to make sure the inspector window is locked. Now we can drag it as our default sprite. And now we're finally going to add our rule tiles. Click on this plus icon to add a new rule tile. I'm gonna create 8 new rule tiles. And now I'm going to drag the top left corner. Then the top corner, then the top right corner, and then the left corner, and then the right corner. And then I'm going to drag the bottom left corner, and the bottom corner, and the bottom right corner. And now all we have to do is to set our rules. And the red X means we won't have any repeating tiles in this direction. And green means we will have more of these tiles repeating in this direction. And Unity will always prioritize its first tile maps. Like the ones on the top will be always be prioritized by Unity. And now we have to create our tile map. Make sure you're on your hierarchy window. Right click and go to 2D object and then tile map, a rectangle. This will create a grid and a tile map for us. Now that we have our tile map set up, there's only one thing left to do. Go to Window, 2D, then Tile Palette. It will open up a new window called Tile Palette. And I'm going to drag it next to our inspector window. And now I'm going to create a new folder called rule tile. This is purely optional. You can just drag it into, you can just create a new tile palette and drag it into there. And now we have to create our tile palette. I'm going to name it rule tile. You can name it whatever you want. And then hit create. And it'll ask us where we need to store our tile palette. So I'm going to go to our assets directory and create a new folder called resources, and inside I'm going to create a new folder called palettes and save it there. And now if we drag our rule tile into our tile palette, we can instantly start drawing. But make sure to select your tile map from the hierarchy and start drawing. And as you can see, we can't draw single tiles, because for that to happen, we need to add more rules to our rule tile. But I'm not going to do that right now, because it's going to be a very long time if we do that. And now I'm going to drag a single grass tile into our tile palette. And I'm going to save it to our palettes folder, just like we did before. And now I'm going to create a bigger brush with our rule tiles. Click on the brush icon, then the edit button on your tile palette. And now I'm going to exit the edit mode. And now if I click on the brush and start painting, as you can see, we're drawing with a much bigger brush, and it's going to save us so much time when we are creating our levels. And now there's only one thing for us to do. As you can see, if we play while we're running, our player is flickering like a light bulb. So to fix that, we have to go to our player and hit inspector. Make sure to click on the lock button on the sprite render component, so our player will be always be rendered on the top. Set O-ring linger to 1, so our player will be always be rendered on the top. And the last thing you should know, that you can also create your animated rule tiles this way. Just make sure to set output to animation, and then set size to how many frames you want into your animation. Drag your first frame and second frame in there, and repeat the same process for all of your rule tiles. And to give you a demonstration, if we hit play, we can see that our tile is now animating. And I'll see in the next one, where we'll be adding Cinemission Virtual Camera to our game.